Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to Let's Play XCOM Apocalypse. We're returning from yet another successful mission. There's an enemy, Cult of Sirius, there. And let me just show you. I'm going to shut off the expensive missiles. Well, not expensive, but hard to get missiles. And we'll see how this Cult of Sirius turbo blazer bike gets destroyed by the lovely medium disruptor beam. It might destroy some of the buildings around it, but it's the sound that's pretty cool. The heavy disruptor beam has the coolest sound, but this one isn't bad either. Where is it? I guess it went in. Okay, never mind then. Turn everything on so I don't forget, because I usually will. Okay, so we were quite lucky in this UFO with brain suckers and everything, but look at this. Live brain suckers, what about dead ones? There, look at that. 8 pods they've brought back. It's just ridiculous how much the aliens are bringing in brain sucker pods so far into the game. I'm really surprised, and I think it's a pretty good tactic, to be completely honest, because... Oh, Universe Antimatter lost both of his shields, but he survived that. How did he... I thought he still had those shields. Oh yeah, because right at the end, they were throwing up, you know, plenty of stuff at us. But we still are getting lots of shields from them, so that's good. X also needs one. Yeah, we've lost quite a few shields. That's quite ouch. It would be nice to just sell them later on if we need money, but they are so useful and nice. Yeah, it's probably best to just keep them. Okay, so last UFO, off we go, and hopefully none of the aliens had escaped. I mean, so far the graph won't really show anything. Not enough ammo to oh good. Okay, Warrior 3. So yeah, we're out of janitor missiles. Let's see if there are any available. I don't think there are. There's the Illyrium, which we've bought. Janitor missiles. Oh yeah, there's plenty available. Nice. Excellent. Let's buy that. It's only 18,000. Where's the profit ones? Yeah, that's pretty good as well. I'm going to be buying those. We can certainly afford it with 200,000 in bank. So yeah, that's good. Let's buy all of that. Okay, so one more UFO, and I kind of like these because the layout is pretty good. And we start on this side. That's actually really, really good. That's where the entrance is. Be angry. Grr. All right, so first of all, I would like them not to waste. Instead of flying immediately, they're already walking, so it's useless then. Don't go that far. Okay, don't see anything just yet. We'll try to hide here and hopefully not have them fire at us just yet or spot us. That would be perfect. I'd have a feeling they will see us. Also send one big fat guy over here. You know, I'm thinking, if he moves over here to this side, wouldn't the entire UFO lean over to that side? Because, you know, bacon and cheeseburger. Bacon cheeseburger, really. Man, I could really go for a nice double bacon cheeseburger right now. That's for damn sure. I am quite hungry right now. Does anyone still remember our live streams and ice cream and cookies and the crystals? Don't lick the crystals. Man, those were good times. We should do live streams again. They were fun. Another question is, I cannot really hide any more people here, so what I'll pro— what are you doing? Holy moly. I'll do is this. I'll place him around here. Yeah, that's that guy. These guys could check around the place, I suppose. Even though usually that team does not get any fighting because, well, there's nothing around there. Although, on rare occasions, there are aliens outside the UFO. There we go. Also gonna park these guys just outside. And hopefully, we're not seen. And if we don't see them, they shouldn't see us. Now, this will give them time to move around a little bit. But as you can see, these rooms are quite tiny usually, so they have problems doing so. Okay, so there's the anthropod, which means... well, not sure where that guy came from. Was it there? Yeah, probably there. I could probably hit him from here, but he might move as well. There's another one. But let's check this little area. What else do we have? More of them. See if there's anyone here. Not for the moment, although they could be cloaked. Yep, there's one there. Not really cloaked. Is that a Devastator or is that again? Why are you... There you go. Come on. Oh, come on. He's right there, man. Seriously? Okay, that's ridiculous. Oh, come on. He's way more accurate than that. Don't give me that. Unfortunately, the toxic guns really aren't strong enough to destroy these missiles, I believe. So we should be fine as far as that goes. There's more of them there. I could just throw some stun grenades there and be done with it. But it's more fun to just kill them. And I'm still not sure whether you get XP for stunning them. Probably do. I don't know. Alright, come on. Let me do stuff. Okay, fine. Can I do something now? Wow, he sees a lot of them. Not a lot of time units left coming there. They were all there, I guess. I just need to check this area. Come on. Okay, it seems to be okay. Good. Right, first team. Now we can start taking some nice pot shots from here. And you are very accurate, Scottish Squarepants. Now, this is not a pooper. They destroyed part of that area. We're just gonna do a couple of shots here. Ah, man. Accurate, but at this range... Alright, fine. Go over here. It's gonna be dangerous, but... There's one. No line of fire. What do you mean? Probably because of that. Oh, no, because of this thing. That's not very nice. Oh, come on. Okay, that's not really working. Get back there. Oh, that's a dimensional missile launcher. That one. Uh-oh. Okay, that's not good. This is also a dangerous area, as you've seen before. If they drop grenades onto the elevator and it falls down, all of that stuff explodes and it's bad. But that is a dimensional missile launcher. That thing is dangerous even if we have shields. So... This is not good. Can you fire at him from there? You cannot. And firing at this guy is just ridiculous because it's so far away and he's cloaked. Whew. This is gonna be interesting. Missiles. Missiles, missiles, missiles. We need cover. So we can get over to them. Much to get there. 24, that's okay-ish. Okay. Okay. One big fat guy's gonna wait there. Squatty square pants. Okay, we get the third team. Cannot really do much with them at the moment because all of those are out of sight. No line of fire. And again, there's no point in trying to shoot this one. I'm kind of still hoping that they would hit him. Why are you going all the way around? Okay. I'm gonna wait over here for now. I'm gonna have you run all the way over here. See if you can actually fire at those skeletoids from here. You should be able to. You're not overly accurate, but this is actually good. That was... Okay, come on. Excellent. No line of fire. Why not? He's right there. Oh, very nice. Ah, but we need to get into cover. Uh-oh. Not enough to get into cover. But enough to get into cover there. Excellent. Okay, that wasn't bad, actually. And in fact... I'm wondering, come on over to this side and take a couple pot shots here. Because you are extremely accurate, Control-Alt. So if you can hit this guy, that would be lovely. Yeah, but this is extreme range here. Come on! Ah, darn it. Was really hoping that would work. Would be nice to get rid of that one. So we've got this team still looking around. Making sure there's no aliens around the UFO. And I don't really think they will find anything. You can see the difference between... Oh, they're all flying armor, actually. Never mind. So, we've got some more people here. You've got a autocannon. That's really not going to come in handy that much right now. I'm going to send you over there and have some more pot shots. Now, you, Mr. Sparaco and Snapshot, are extraordinarily accurate. Extraordinarily accurate. Still no line of... fire. Oh, that was nice. I'm actually wondering, can you... No, no line of fire. That was lovely. Okay, so if you go over here, you should have line of sight towards... How? How is it no line of fire? Are there two of them here? Because it looks like there's two of them bunched up. You see that? Yeah, there are two of them. So if I just fire towards here, should be able to hit them. Come on. Ah, come on, game. Okay, get back into cover. This is nice, though. How far can you go? That's good enough. I want to make sure that that place up here does not have a bunch of them. Now, the problem is, with cloaking, they could still be around here and we wouldn't see them. So we gotta be kind of careful about this. This is still dangerous, having only one person there. And I think that's it. Let's end the turn. So, the dimensional missile launcher is gonna be a problem. Uh-oh. I think he's out of time units. Oof, lie. Nice. Pays off to get back into cover. Oh, one of them died. That guy died. So it was the effects of toxins. Well, I mean, it sounds cool to say effects of the toxins, but really, the toxigen does nothing but do normal damage, just like the rest of the weapons. They all do just damage. But it must have caused some fatal wounds, and that guy just basically bled out. But, you know, we can pretend that it was... We can pretend that it was... oh, hello. There's a thing down there. That's not good. We can pretend that it was the effects of the toxin that took, you know... It took effect in his bloodstream or whatever they have, and it annihilated him. That's cool. There's nothing there. Shouldn't be anything here either, so... I mean, there still can be, because, well, cloaking. So, first of all, I want to do this. Not really sure where this guy came from. Fortunately, none of this stuff exploded. It would have been pretty bad. We could pick up that extra... Disruptor shield. I believe they work immediately, but I'm not entirely sure about that, so don't... Why is this guy dead? Did he die of fatal wounds as well? He must have. Look at that. There's so many of them. This is so nice. Good night. I'm just checking that they don't have brain sucker launchers. And they don't appear to. The guy had an entropy launcher. So where's our friend with the missile launcher? Oh, jeez. There's a lot of them everywhere. I love that sound they do. I don't know why. It's just very satisfying for some reason. Okay, there's nothing up there, so let's check this side. We don't really have a lot of time units coming down, unfortunately. Oh, we saw them there, but it was probably... what? I don't know what it was. Okay, so nothing you see there for now. I gotta check this air. Oh, only 13. Let's... where is he? Is he there? Just see the spitters. I guess we've already killed him. It must be one of these guys. Oh, bloody hell. We don't have enough. We're 2 time units short to pick this one up. Well, I need someone else to go and pick it up then. I'm really surprised they still use that. That guy might have the missile launcher. I could swear I saw a missile launcher, the dimensional one. So is it these guys? No? What? Where is it then? Hello. That wasn't too great, but oh well. Doesn't matter, it's just spitters. I think it might be just these guys left, to be honest. Maybe a skeletoid or two hidden somewhere. Lovely. Was that it? Yes, it was. Perfect. That was very good. Look at that. Almost 700. Now, the moment of truth, I could have sworn that was a dimensional missile launcher. Let's also save 5-4. And bring our lovely music back. Are we gonna shoot at something? No. Yeah, like I always say, just in case you're confused, if you don't know about Apocalypse and why I'm so worried about, you know, our vehicles encountering enemy vehicles from other corporations, it's because they usually will try to destroy that vehicle with everything they have. Well, usually always, which also means that most of the time they will do so much collateral to the city. It's just ridiculous, and it's definitely not worth it, because you get nothing really for it. I mean, the organization you're destroying the stuff from is, you know, it's gonna pay a financial price a little bit, but that's about it. Oh, wow. Look at that. Extropians are now allied for some reason. Interesting. Oh, no. Music. I love that music. Okay, small disruption shield is gonna be done soon. So let's see. No, there's no dimensional missile launcher. I could have sworn there was one there. Huh. There's this disruptor inversion bomb. Interesting. Yeah, I could have sworn they use them, but I suppose not. Now, I cannot remember. Let's see. Toxin type B. And more toxicants, but that's fine. I cannot remember. Look at that. 20,000 skill hours. It only sells for 4,000. there's a personal disruptor shield. You can see that how expensive it is. It is 14,000 skill hours. And it's definitely not worth to actually sell it if you're making them yourself. But let's see. Cannot remember whether the cloaking... oh, it's not available here, is it? Darn it, because it's not researched yet. I think it does not fit into a 4x4. I think it needs a 3x3. No, wait a second, does it? Because that would be great, actually. We could use cloaking in the... holster, whatever it is. Well, I suppose that's the belt. I don't know. Either way, let's make sure that everyone has stuff replenished, even though the game should do that. And we've got 16 shields again, which is very nice. We've used quite a bit of toxins. I love seeing all that bright stuff to see just how much our soldiers have improved. That's so cool. Yeah, we lost a fair few shields, and we are running low on toxins, as per usual, but we are building more, and as soon as those extra toxicons are complete, we will be making even more toxins with both of the workshops. And the advanced workshops is 7 days from completion. So now, I'm pretty sure that when we fast forward, we'll see an alarm, which sucks, but that's the name of the game. I'm pretty sure that some of the aliens probably had escaped. Let's see. No, nothing yet. And now everything is rearmed because we bought those missiles. Let's see. Yep, there it is. I knew it. So where's Mutant Alliance? Wait a second. Weren't they? No. Mutant Alliance. Let me remember. It's these guys. Okay. And of course, they get a bunch of places. What, only those two? Oh, excellent. Okay. But yeah, as per usual, there are aliens that have escaped. So, very annoying, but, well, oh well. I'm gonna save again. There's a enemy there, but too far away to actually fire upon. So we're gonna save it here, and then find them. Stop. Oh. I was wondering why it was slightly damaged. funny. Now they're probably gonna fire upon that one. Okay, so do I want to let them fire? No, I don't, because there's too many buildings here and the slums are very easy to destroy. So, are they here? No, they're not. So they're in the other place, which means we have to reload unless we want to lose even more reputation with them, which sucks. So you go back and you go to this other place. Yeah, that one. And don't fire. Come on. Music is so good in this game. Okay, I'll leave it on... Well, no. He'll fire that stupid Cult of Sirius civilian car, I'm sure of it, as they leave, but I'll forget about it. I'm pretty sure I will. Okay. So slums again. Oh, that's excellent. We see them right from the start. That is brilliant. Because it saves us a lot of trouble. So where are they? Oh, it's just an egg. Okay, that's not that great. I was kind of hoping it would be that multi-worm we heard. But alas. So that egg is there. We want to kind of avoid it. I mean, it cannot really do much damage to us at all, especially with shields. But just in case, we do want to avoid it. Any unnecessary damage. So we're going to go in here. Not to the second floor. Oh god. Wasting time units. It's not much they have left though. Oh, there's a roof. I never actually realized. How does one... Oh wow. Huh. Interesting. Never actually realized there was a roof. And I suppose these guys can go to the second floor then. Because, you know, those other teams will go to the second floor as well. Oh, you guys don't have flying armor? Brilliant. Okay, I think that's about it. Let's end the turn. The egg cannot really do anything because, well, it does not see us anymore. And it cannot move because it's an egg. Center on massage. Run, civilians, run! Okay. That is good. I'm assuming we're going to see that multi-worm now. That's been going around here. Nothing yet. Hmm. Okay. It might be upstairs then. They usually bunch up, although this is probably going to be a case where there's very few aliens about. Oh my god. You could have had spare time units there, but you just completely wasted them. Oh, jeez. Okay, second one. Second team, I mean. I suppose I can have them go up here. Even though I already have a team here. Well, half of the team. Ready and waiting. And that way. And you can also keep a lookout there. And you can check this corridor out. But nothing there. Good. So third team. Check this area. We know there's a multi-worm somewhere. There's not enough time units there. The problem again is multi-worms, and we mostly have just toxicants. We have one person with an autocannon, which could deal with the stupid hyperworms that come out. And once again, no, actually, no, there's not more to the map there. Is there more to the map here? No, this is it. This is the building and that's it. Okay. Well, that's not too bad. Where's the rest of this team? One here. Control Alt. I really should get them flying armor if at all possible. Wait a second. This team is up here, right? Yeah. So she should come up here. And it's too far, of course. You guys are checking out the roof. Which I didn't even know existed. These maps are giant. And of course, this is just half of the map that could actually appear if we had more people. It's quite ridiculous if you ask me. But what a lovely establishment they have here. Lovely. And nothing else here, really. Waste, but oh well. Was kind of expecting that. Let's get everyone up here. Multi-worms, come out. I've got some the food for you, I guess. Although they eat everything, so I guess everything is food. Come out. You've got the autocannon. You will be instrumental in this. Unfortunately, you're already out of stamina. Oh dear. That would really help, though. I think I'm just gonna end the turn, to be honest. See where the multi-worm comes out. Oh, that was very quick. Please don't tell me the multi-worm was somewhere outside on the ground and now has escaped. Well, I mean, it would have been the end of this mission if he did, probably, because I'm assuming it's just a multi-worm and a couple of eggs. Nothing. They are sneaky little things, aren't they? And that's kind of a weird thing to say, because they're not little at all. And check the windows, because, yeah, there's nothing else to the map here. Hmm. Alright, this part, yeah. We'll probably be here somewhere. Hello? Excuse me. Still nothing. Nope. 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 Oh, what a lovely apartment this is. Absolutely wonderful. Still nothing? I have a feeling all of a sudden we'll see a bunch of hyperworms, but if there were hyperworms in this on this map, we would have heard them by now. Anyway, I hope you are enjoying this as much as I do playing it, and I hope you will join me in the next part of XCOM Apocalypse. Where is our guy with the autocannon? He's down here. Brilliant. That's not great. He's gonna have to come upstairs now. Can he go past? Well, you'll have to move. Just move. Just move. Flipping hell! You gotta be shitting me. Look at this. Look at this monumental waste of time units. Ah, oh, I hate that so much. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. We're gonna continue next time. I'm gonna save here and have a good one. Bye-bye.